This will likely be, good morning, Haresh. This is likely going to be a short one because I was so busy this week working on working on a lot of different things, but I still had enough information to share. So we're at 9. I want to give everyone back their Easter for those that celebrate. So, you know, first, happy Easter for everyone. Really didn't get much done on the deck, and that was really because of two different reasons. Number one, really, I'm helping out a not-for-profit do a webinar versus something they were planning to do on-premise, and we've been making good progress on that, but as usual, taking up a fair amount of time and learning a lot of lessons, some of which we're going to share here. So for those new to all of this, what I would tell you, this is something that I've been assembling. Even though I have through April 12th, this is really last week, so it has not changed much. If you want to get the deck, all you need to do is go to that address, which is www.keeppace.com/coronavirus job info, and that will give you the PDF with all of the links. As of, again, last week, I really didn't see a whole lot this week, but there's one or two things that I did want to share, and then open it up for questions if there are any questions. So the first one, the ongoing challenges for those that are renting. So there were two different ones, and again, it's going to vary based on where you're located. This happens to be for New Jersey. If I see something that happens at a federal level, I will post it. So the first one really talked about a wealth, and this is on investopedia.com. So if you just look this up in Google, I'll have to get this into the deck, but if you look this up on Google, you should find this easy enough. And one of the things I liked about this was dated as of March 30th, so even though it's a couple of weeks old, there are a list of different programs that are out there depending on where you fit, ranging from rental housing that's covered under eviction notices, various CARES Act, which is the program, the federal program, various Fannie Mae, social services. I mean, it was pretty interesting the amount of information that was in this particular one. The second is, and I guess this is dated as of yesterday, this was on NewJersey.com, where Governor Murphy is asking those that are getting screwed by their landlords in some way, shape, or form to report those challenges as well. So that, again, and then if you watch last week where I tell you how to go through Twitter, I think on here, was it on here? Hang on a second. Where was it? I thought I saw it quickly. Was it on Twitter? Yeah, so one of the Twitter hashtags, so let's just do this real quick while we're here, was Cancel Rent New Jersey. That's a new Twitter, a new hashtag. So let's just do a quick look here. Boy, why is that so big? I don't know why that zoomed out. Oh, I know why, because I didn't fix it from last time, that's why. So let's look at what Cancel Rent New Jersey is getting us for the latest. And again, now you're going to start getting people that are running for office. Various people are trying to at least give some information on Cancel Rent New Jersey. So again, use Twitter. Go back to last week. I go through this, but it's pretty easy enough, right? Go to search.twitter.com. And again, the new hashtag for this week for those in New Jersey is Cancel Rent NJ. Just for giggles and chuckles, let me try PA. I just want to see something here real quick. Cancel Rent PA. Let's do California. So one of the other things that I just realized I forgot to include last week, if you look at the hashtag, and again, I'll expand this just a little bit here so you can all see it. One of the things that is not uncommon on a hashtag, now remember, hashtags are made up. We can make any hashtag up. It doesn't have to be registered. It doesn't have to be approved. It's basically anything that starts with a pound sign and a bunch of characters after that. So in this particular one, cancel rent starts to become what we'll call the base. And then if you notice, I just did CA, let's do New York. These things tend to catch on where they will change it by state. So whatever state you're in, if you add that or just change the New Jersey or put your state abbreviation, that will probably work for you. Again, it's only as valid as what people are tweeting, but that's going to be the hashtag. If you're a renter and you're looking for more information, this is probably the fastest way I think you're going to find it. So again, last episode or last week, I did the whole setup on Twitter and how to use it. It's really pretty straightforward. Go to search.twitter.com. And again, hashtag in this particular case for where I started was cancel rent New Jersey. But there's loads of whatever. The only other thing I had for this week, and it came up with some of the video work that I've been doing and a lot of what I'll call the virtual meeting work I've been doing. So I'm going to show a couple of things here. And again, in no particular order, so I'm going to hide that for a second. One of the things I want to show you is obviously there's a lot of things I can change here. One of which is I have a green screen behind me. You may or may not realize that. I'm projecting my desktop onto this. My computer background is that dark gray as you see it. So in a sense, when you're looking at a number of pieces that I've put together that work for me. And one of the things I want to really highlight is it's silly, silly things that really end up making a pretty big difference. So again, I covered this last week, but again, based on what we saw this week, it's part of the whole sharing. So the first, I hate lighting. Lighting is just, I understand why people go to school and learn about lighting because it's an interesting beast. One of the things I would tell you to do is get light bulbs that are daylight, because I think daylight works the best. One of the things that you find is that they're soft white and fluorescent lights. And what happens is each, believe it or not, gives off its own color. And while you don't see that while you're necessarily walking around the house, it really becomes apparent when you're on a video. So one of the things I would tell you to do when you're doing your testing is get natural light bulbs and test out how that looks. That's item number one. Item number two, give me a second. I wanted to demonstrate something for you as to why I'm using a dark shirt, in this case, a blue shirt. So let me just come off to the side a second. So for me, this is a white shirt. Personally, I don't think this puts me in my proverbial best light, as it were. Because if you notice, and again, I don't think I differentiate. Now, I've got this pasty white skin as it is. It blends in with the white shirt, and there's really no contrast between myself, my shirt, and my background. I think I kind of look like an amorphous blob, as it were. So again, I want you to see the difference even for what you wear and what your lighting is. This is stuff you need to test out way in advance, obviously. So again, I'm not a big fan of the white shirt. I don't think it really pops on the screen. And again, you can see the difference between this and... put that over there. And the blue shirt. And yes, I'm wearing pants as well. So anyway, so number one, we got lights. Number two, figure out what works best for you, right? You got to take your skin tone and, all of those dynamics into place that say, what is going to make me look the best? The next thing I want to show you, and again, this is work David Schuckman had put this up on his page, and I wanted to show a couple of things that I thought stood out here in terms of how you can look or how different things appear. In this particular case, and again, this was a snapshot in time, but I want you to look at the nuance of things first. You can notice that some of these pictures look a little clearer than others. So to me, investing in a high-resolution webcam, like a 4K webcam, it might set you back $100 or whatever they go for right now, but I think, again, when you're trying to make that appearance and you're trying to make yourself pop, that's one thing you can do. In this particular one, you can tell the lighting. If the lighting is too close to you, so if you literally have a light source somewhere around you, you'll notice on this particular one how it's washed out. And again, that's probably something you want to address way before you have your first interview, just what you look like. In the lower left, again, a little dark. The problem in this particular one is where windows are. Now, here's another challenge. If you're testing this at night, you want to make sure you're testing in the same time period that your interview is going to be in. Because in this particular one, daylight, this is going to be a very different, I'm sorry, if you were testing this at night, it's going to be a very different appearance than if it's in the day. So ideally, you want to avoid windows whenever possible. In this particular one here, too distant from the camera. You want to have at least, I don't know, I would think chest, mid-chest up, something that allows you to be seen. Whether or not you do headsets, I don't know one way or the other. I have done one with a headset. I think if you use, if you don't have something that's big and bulky, and rather you have something that's kind of small and compact that you can wear in your ears, you know, I don't think it's that big of a deal. In fact, if I really wanted to, I could take my setup here and actually, well, you'll get the idea. I could put it over my back, so it's actually hanging off the back. So, you know, I'm not necessarily disrupting anybody in the house, but, you know, I don't necessarily get any of the echo or anything. Ugh. Look at that. So anyway, you get the idea, right, that it's going to be barely noticeable rather than a big headset on. I'm more of a fan of less is more, shall we say. So I would tell you to think about a smaller set of headphones. The other thing that's really important, and it depends on how you are set up. Now, I have somewhat of a unique setup here. You can't see it. One day I'll probably try and take a picture of all of this. My camera is about, I don't know, what would that be? 8 feet. My camera is about 8 feet in front of me, and I have a zoom. So I'm not dealing with, and this is the top of my monitor, I'm not dealing with a webcam here. I'm actually dealing with a 4K webcam that goes through HDMI and a whole bunch of nonsense you don't care about. Now, for me, if I look down, as an example, if I were to look at my screen and you focus on my eyes, you're immediately going to watch my eyes. So if I put my eyes off this way, you're going to see it. Additionally, if you start looking at the screen in this particular case, and again, your mileage will vary. It depends on your setup. One of the things that you want to try to do is figure out where you need to be seated in relationship to where that camera is. Because if you're looking down, now all of a sudden you're not necessarily making eye contact anymore. And you want to make sure you're creating a conversation. So depending on how your camera is. Now, I was playing with someone yesterday. Even the angle of the laptop screen, they were using their laptop and the built-in webcam that came with the laptop. Well, now all of a sudden you were starting at different angles. Are you looking up? Are you coming from underneath? You really want to figure out a way to make sure you're making eye contact with the camera. If you're looking down at the camera, they're going to see it. So even on some of those situations where you have a kind of a picture-in-picture display, be cognitive of where your eyes are, because that's going to, what you see is what they're seeing, basically. And I think those were the big, and distance is another one, by the way. It's really subtle, and again, it's going to be based on your camera and the capabilities within your camera. But again, the farther away you are or the wider you are, more of your motions are going to be seen. So if your camera is much closer to your face, you're going to get to cheat a little bit, as it were. The farther away you are, any head movement that you make is really going to be noticeable. I guess one last thing I'll show you. Hold on one second. I'm going to change one of the lights just so you can get an appreciation of something. You actually see me go through my bag. Look at that. So let's see. I had this is 2 and 4. 2 and 4. Let's turn these off a second. My back. It didn't pick me up. There it is. There we go. We're coming back. So a couple things I want you to see. You'll notice, you see that square that's around my head? Well, you're starting to see, and believe it or not, all this schmutz behind me, that's the green screen that's now coming out. Because one of the things you need to know about a green screen is the more lighting you have, the better. In this particular case, the fact that I turned off one of my lights, the software has a much harder time because this side is a darker green now than this side. So what's happening is everything that's kind of off on this side looks pretty good. And everything that starts to go on this side, not so good. And again, it's a matter of which green is it picking up? And it's called chroma key, but it's trying to key out the green and allow me to put something over it. So the fact that I've got that really crazy shadow is a function of the lighting. So let me turn that back on. And again, in a second, you should see this should have corrected itself. And you'll notice how easily it corrected itself. So lighting really is, you know, it's the proverbial pain in the ass, as it were. But it really takes a little. And again, I've learned this over time. It doesn't have to be on top of you. If it's on top of you, it's going to wash you out. You typically want to get these back a little bit. But again, it's going to be based on your room, based on the stands that you have. So it's something I would tell you to focus on to get ready for a video interview. The only other thing I had, it was on here and I think I took it away, didn't I? Hang on one second. Oh, silly George. Hang on. There it is. Put it in the wrong screen. And then again, you know, one of the things I would tell you, you're going to find all of these other hints, which are, you know, typical about your surroundings. I would just say to you, you know, find as many of these as you can. Create your own master list. If you have clocks that chime, if you have animals that make noises, you know, if you're on a busy street, I think there's a long list of things that you could put together based on where you're going to do this from. But those are really the big pieces I had to share this week. I actually did more time than I thought I had. I didn't have, again, for those joining late, I didn't have, I was really busy with a couple of projects this week, so I wasn't as on top of things. So really a quick review for those that had joined. We talked a little bit about renters, so there's an Investopedia link I have to get in. I know there has been some conversations or discussions, at least on NewJersey.com, that the governor is now saying to basically report in people that are abusing the system. And then we talked about, you know, you can go back last week if you're not used to Twitter, but on search.twitter.com, the hashtag is cancel rent New Jersey. And then depending on what state you're in, you just put your two state abbreviation in and away you go. So that's pretty much what I had. I have a lot of studying I'm going back to. So just reaching out. Anyone have any questions before we go? One of the other things that might come out of this, I know David Chuckman, who I know through the Breakfast Club, he put a really good email together comparing some of the tools together. Maybe next week we'll talk a little bit about that between Zoom, GoToMeeting, what's free, Skype, some of the different options that are out there. One of the things that I've been a little underwhelmed with is for some of these tools that are getting a lot of press, Zoom being one of them, actually surprised at how, I think the word I used yesterday was Spartan, the feature set is. I actually expected it to be a little broader than it was or a little more flexible than it was, and that's not the case. But again, depending on what you're trying to do, each of these tools has its own value prop. So again, I think in the months ahead, we're going to see more of these virtual type meetings rather than less. I think now that the seeds have been planted, people are going to play with this more. So I think that leads to video interviews. I think that gets us back to the lighting and why I covered it, the shirts, the direct, you know, the whole nine yards. So You know, if you're home with nothing to do, basically, I would tell you to start playing around with your webcam and get that right, or at least understand how to get your environment to looking the best that it can be. So with that, I think I pretty much have what I wanted to share this week. I'm not seeing any questions from anybody. So I think we're good. Again, happy Easter for those that celebrate. And I should have more time this, well, maybe I'll have more time the later part of next week. I'm committed to a couple of things Monday through Wednesday. But I should be able to get an update out, again, based on the news as well. Should be an update that I'll get out this coming week. So that's it. Again, have a good day, everyone. And we're going to do this again next week. See you soon. Bye.